Okay, this is Jimmy Jive, and you're listening to Motor City Rock Talk. Today, I'm going to be interviewing a band from across the river, across the Ambassador Bridge. And like I was telling them, I don't normally interview bands to the Detroit metropolitan area, but I consider Windsor pretty much a part of Detroit, and I have dual citizenship, so I'm going to let it slide. Anyway, how you guys doing tonight? This is Blasternaut I'm talking to.
Well, hey.
Ready to rock, all right. So anyway, one of you guys, I don't care which one of it is, tell me a little bit about how Blasternaut got started and, like, who formed the band and, you know, who the members are.
Originally the members, so this is Ted speaking, myself, Tome, Jack, and Inky Star, and T. Firneno was our drummer on our first record. And then, basically, Tome and I have been founding members and stayed in the band the whole time, for better or for worse.
Yeah. Okay.
Inky Star left the band in 1998-99 and was replaced by Juergen Schweder. He was living in Detroit at the time, from Germany, Nuremberg, Germany.
Mm-hmm.
And then Steve Firneno was replaced by Jimmy Winales. Jimmy played band until about 2005 or so. Interestingly enough, our original drummer, his brother, replaced Jimmy and is the current drummer of our band, which is Johnny.
Oh,
it's almost like getting a young girl. We upgraded. Yeah. Younger girlfriend.
Keep it the family.
So current membership is Ted, Johnny, and
you. Are you guys all, I mean, other than Johnny, obviously, are the rest of the band all basically, obviously the guy from Germany who's living in Baltimore, are you guys all Canadians then, other than those two?
Basically, like, Tom and I are Canadian, Johnny's American, and Juergen is
dual citizen. American, German. We're actually quite culturally diverse.
Yeah, I know. That's great. But where did the band start out as far as playing? Would that have been in Windsor or that area or what?
We started more on the Windsor side, but actually, to be honest, we probably played more over in Michigan and stateside
100%
than we did over, played Toronto quite a bit, but other than that, we toured more over states like Chicago, New York,
Cleveland,
Lexington.
Now, is that because there weren't enough clubs over there? You just didn't like the water? What was the reasoning for that?
Well, the cities are closer together.
Mm-hmm. A lot better in Michigan, too.
Yeah.
A little bit of both, yeah. A little bit of both.
We did play up in Montreal and Ottawa. We did do something in
Vancouver.
Yeah, we did get up to Vancouver for a hike. Tried to do a lot of the North by Northeast, Canadian Music League, BMW, all those type of industry festivals. And we tried to make tours out of them.
Right.
Get more exposure.
And what year was it the band formed? What year was that?
So we formed in 1997. That was the first, maybe 96 really, but the first album came out in 97. Second album was 99,000. Then we came out with an EP 2001. And then the last full-length record was 2006. And then we played shows right up until our last show to play ever was in Windsor in 2010. Yep, played soon.
And why was that? I mean, did you guys go off? I know Ted went off and was doing something, but did the rest of the band have other projects on the side, or what caused that to happen?
So we all started doing our own thing. Life sort of took over. We sort of drifted apart, and one day we started talking and realized, hey, play a guitar player. Decided to press one of our CDs that we don't have any more copies of, and we're going to make a vinyl of that CD now.
A limited run of our third Promolicious.
When do you think that vinyl will be out?
We're actually releasing it the night of our reunion show.
Oh, very cool.
Over and seen.
Right, right. And how many copies do you think you get? How many copies you haven't pressed?
We pressed 100, and they gave us a few extras, so I got to take 100.
Will it be available anywhere? I mean, if you don't sell it out at your show, which hopefully you do, but if you don't, how could somebody get a copy of that?
We might stock some of the local record stores around Windsor, and we'll see how this show goes then.
Right.
About maybe doing another Detroit show next year sometime.
Oh, for sure we're going to do a Detroit show. 100%.
Yeah, I hope so. I was going to say, because when I talked to Ted last, I thought you had mentioned something about possibly, in October, but being like at the Token Lounge or something. Did that change? Was that something you weren't able to, set up?
You know, we could have done it. We just wanted to do it with the correct angle on the bill. Couldn't line it up correctly, so we thought, let's just hold off for now and we'll space it out a bit.
Oh, okay.
We're just relearning all these songs and the two shows back.
Well, the other problem, too, is Ford Field was all booked up for a Lion's
Net.
And we tried to push some buttons, but it just wasn't tight. Yeah, tailgating.
Yeah, you guys would have warmed up the Lions really well. They could, they would have really liked that. That would have been great, for a halftime show or something. Now, you put out three albums, and I know, like you said, you played quite a bit in the States, Detroit, Cleveland, and of course, as far as Canada, Montreal, all the way out to Vancouver. What was the farthest that you toured in the United States as far as that?
Probably New York City, right? Manhattan.
And whereabouts in New York?
One club was called Arlene's Grocery,
and it was like Mercury Bridge. Yeah, Mercury Lounge. They're right down in Soho. I actually remember exactly where.
Right.
It was part of the CMW festival.
Did you say you guys played at a grocery store?
The place was called Arlene's Grocery, but it was a club. Actually, it was a pretty cool club. They had
cool.
They had a full multi-track studio in the basement that you could record live shows and then mix it afterwards.
Wow.
We recorded our show there. One day we should actually release it.
Yeah. I didn't know where it is.
I got it at home. I got the recording at home.
You should. Yeah, absolutely. Do you remember that show? Was it a good night?
Yeah, it was a good night. Great. We had a, remember Roadrunner Records.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's right.
You guys were on Roadrunner, you said?
They showed some interest in us at the time, but we didn't.
They just came to check us out. They were there.
Oh, okay.
All of us, but we couldn't find them after the gig, so I don't know. I don't know if that's a good or bad. I think they're looking for groceries.
Yeah.
And they're taking a stand, and we're like, wrong place.
They got some bacon and eggs and headed out. All right. As far as this reunion show, how long have you guys been rehearsing to get ready for it? How long have you started to do that? Because, Ted, I know that you've been playing, with Stereo Babe quite a bit over the summer. So when did you guys start rehearsing for this?
Literally, we practice it, but tonight is our second practice.
But surprisingly, a lot of the stuff is coming back fairly.
And we're rehearsing every week right up to the show. So just 30 minutes ago, we were doing songs from the first album for the first time in 15 years. Yeah. It sounded great.
Do you guys record any of your rehearsals to listen back and say, wow, that part was good, that part was a little rusty? Or
my old band, you could do that. And I thought that sometimes that was a good thing to do. I think with this one, though, I think we're good.
Yeah, we're good.
Ted, do you do most of the singing this band?
Yeah, I'm the lead.
So you're not having any trouble as far as the range of some of the stuff? Because, not that they...
I'll answer that. No, he's doing Fox. Give him a sip.
Are you ready?
That's why I'd like to hear that live, just to see how you guys sounded live back in the day. Because I noticed that on Facebook today, you guys have got some kind of little commercial blurb about the reunion show. Is that something you guys just made up in the basement somewhere, or did you have that done in the studio? How'd you do that?
That reel, part of our... We only put out two official music videos, and that was part of from Supersonic, and it was like some alive portion of the video.
But you can find that on YouTube, or on our vinyl release, second song.
Yeah.
But so that's not recent. That's just something you guys put up to...
We put up.
I get you.
A video.
But the original video, the full video, is on YouTube.
Yeah, it is on YouTube.
If you just search Supersonic Blasternaut.
That's another thing. The name of the band, who came up with that, and is there any significance to it? Does it mean anything, or was it just like, hey, let's call ourselves Blasternaut?
It was actually my big brother, the original drummer, came up with that name. And I'll never forget, I think I was like 17, and Steve's like 10 years older than me, and he just comes in, we're both living at home with our parents, and he just comes into my bedroom, I'm like doing my algebra homework, and he just bursts into my room, and he goes, John, I got the name for the band, Blasternaut. I'll never forget that, it was hilarious.
I'm like, that's cool. So yeah, well, it was my big brother.
No, no, we had a record deal, but the only condition was we have to change our name. The guy didn't like our old name. He says we need a new name ASAP, and that was it.
The original name was Princess Black. We were a little bit more back then, and
he said it wasn't marketable. Yeah, get rid of that name.
What was that name again? What was that?
Princess Black.
Yeah, that's a little out there. I like
it. Big brother was so excited about his idea.
Yeah, I like Blasternaut a lot better. Now, was he into sci-fi? Was he wanting to be an astronaut? What, did he ever say how he came up with that, or did he have a dream? What?
Yeah, I think, well, actually, if you hear on the first record, one of the first singles is called Outer Space.
Okay.
And the sound of that song, actually, I think the name Astronaut actually fits with the vibe of that song.
That's our first video, too.
It is. Outer Space. Yeah. Yeah. And I think he was listening and learning that song because he had to go into the studio. You know, mm-hmm. with the band. Before they had to go to the studio to record that album, he listened to the song Outer Space, inspired him to come up with what's more than an actor, a Blasternaut.
That's really cool. Now, with that kind of name and with that kind of theme, how come you guys didn't do any videos dressed as astronauts? Couldn't find the wardrobe? What was the problem?
Oh, never know what the future holds. Right?
I remember Mark Berry, our producer, label guy, he loved it.
Yeah, he loved it.
Yeah, it had power to it. Sound is really in your face. You're rock.
The album's a great
rock bass kind of sound. But a ticket does, I was just saying that I think the name does suit the band. You know, we're pure rock, hard rock, the idea is
what you'll have at one of our...
Right. Are you going to be doing quite a varied mix from all the albums as far as the show?
So to answer your question, we're playing all four releases for about, it's going to be at least a 100-minute show.
Wow.
Maybe longer, all of them.
Yeah. Suck it out of hand here.
120. Like a Bruce Springsteen.
75 minutes sounds better.
Sorry.
Yeah, what's cool, though, is all of our records actually are very, they have their own sound.
Oh, yeah, I noticed that, yeah. Yes.
So you're in for, you know, if you come out to the show, you're in for a very varietal night of rock. You know, it's all still rock, but each album is potpourri. Yeah, a veritable.
Refresh my memory. Did you say you hadn't played together in 15 years? Is that right?
That's right, yeah.
Okay, as far as doing this material, you guys hadn't played together, and this is what I think you said, your second rehearsal. Have you written any new songs yet, or are you just being lazy?
we're just trying to remember what we wrote 20, 30 years ago.
Yeah, I do feel a little bit like a cover band relearning our songs a little bit.
That's kind of fun, though.
Yeah. Yeah, do you guys do any covers? Are you going to do any covers?
We have a surprise, actually. We do have a surprise that you'll have to come out to the show to find us a surprise.
Come on, tell me, are you going to do Trooper, Raise a Little Hell? Come on, that's a Canadian classic.
That's my arm.
No one knows who's that. Let's stick to April Wine or at least something.
You mean we're not doing La Villa Stracciato?
Yeah, there you go. The long version, the live version. The other thing I was going to ask you was, you know, back when you guys had the 3-4 album releases or whatever, did you guys in any way get any kind of radio airplay as far as Canadian radio, U.S. radio, college, anything like that?
The one song that actually you saw the little reel of, if you look on YouTube, that particular song got the most radio play of any of our releases. And actually, there's a few stations actually out in Western Canada that had it in high rotation. We never got out there to play any shows. We should have started to get out there at some point.
Yeah, we got scattered airplay across Canada, even Sarnia, Calgary, like different areas, even different songs I think we did.
Lloydminster, Alberta. We were heavy rotation.
Yeah.
Lloydminster, Alberta.
Lloydminster, Alberta. I don't even know where that is, but...
Look up. It's an important place.
Yes.
Then one day spoke up in number one in Japan.
I was going to say, a lot of times bands don't know it, but they're big over in Europe or Japan or China and don't even know it, and they just can't pick the book of flight. But I mean, in your own country, damn it, you should at least get in your mini bikes or your bus and just get the hell out there and do one show before the people forget about you.
Oh, you never know.
You never know. So are there any plans? You got the reunion show coming up. You said you're hoping to do some other shows. Are there any plans beyond that as far as like maybe sticking together this time, doing a little bit more shows or touring? Or is this more or less just a kind of nostalgic thing?
We're open to anything.
We're pretty open to whatever.
We'll see how Windsor and the Token Lounge go, and we'll take it from there, really.
Mm-hmm. Plans on possibly doing any more recording, or is that also going to be dependent on how these shows go?
Made no plans, really, but you never
one day at a time. Yeah, we don't know yet.
There is some unreleased material that we've had
tucked away,
mm-hmm. demoed out. Never know. We haven't really talked about it, though. We're just trying to get through this show, trying to remember everything.
One day at a time. I get you. Now, whereabouts in Windsor are you playing again, and what's the date?
So it's relatively close to downtown. It's October 19th at the Backstage, which is the Windsor Players Club on the name of the street, Langlois.
Mm-hmm.
Langlois, yeah.
Had you guys played there before?
I played there in another band several times. It's a really great club, really good sound, good lighting there. It's a really good venue to see any band. They have a lot of tribute bands there, but they have some original stuff there as well. And we're pretty excited to play there. So,
and it's only 5 minutes from the tunnel, so it's not deep into Windsor.
Oh, okay.
The capacity is 1/5, so it's a kind of a smaller place, but it sounds really good. And that was the most important. We just want to sound good that night.
Oh, of course, that's very important, especially after not being out there for that many years and want to come back. You had mentioned earlier that there had been some minor issues or whatever about the bands you wanted to have on the bill. Who are these bands that you've selected or you having with you?
Well, actually, one band that we'd like to do a show with is Steve Firneno's other band, Johnny's Brother, and right. That's Fate. They've done some reunion shows, and we might do something together with them in the new year. I talked to Mike Smith about that, and we can line it up and make it work this time. Hopefully, that'll happen. They're called Fate.
It's Space?
Fate, yeah. F-A-C-E.
Oh, okay.
Like wipe, right, like okay. Wipe that on
right,
your
I get you.
Fate.
Okay, I hear you now. Now, is that because you couldn't convince them to get Romeo Rock back together? What's going on with that?
they've been there already. They've done their
research. Really?
Yeah. That's basically my second family, that band, at this point.
I know.
Okay, well, you kind of dodged my original question. Who are the bands or bands that are going to be playing with you at this reunion show?
So this particular show in Windsor, we're having a DJ open up. There was a pretty popular goth club that was around in the late 90s, early 2000s called Changes by Night.
Mm-hmm.
And we hired a DJ from that club to do a reunion show for people that used to go to that club.
Basically like Windsor's version of City Club on Cass and Bagley.
Okay.
In the day.
Yeah.
So he's going to be spinning, whatever, Old Ministry and whatever.
Yeah.
Nine Inch Nail, Front 242, Skinny Puppy, that kind
Wait,
of stuff.
Wait, not P. Diddy? I thought we were getting P. Diddy.
Oh.
So there's no other than the DJ, there's no other bands opening for you or doing anything?
No, there's no other bands. We're the only band.
Okay, and you couldn't get a juggler or a ventriloquist open for you? You had to stick with the...
Well, I do card tricks. Yeah. So we just decided it's our vinyl release party, it's our first gig back.
Right.
Better just to do it by ourselves.
Yeah, that's true. That's a great idea. Now, where did you have that record pressed?
It was actually pressed over in Europe.
Yeah, Czech Republic.
Yeah, because it's only a 10-inch, there's only so many pressing plants that can do 10-inch, so we had to go to Europe.
It was mastered in Cleveland, though.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's right.
And then the Toronto prep plants couldn't do it. They sent it to Czech Republic to get it prepped.
Now, why a 10-inch instead of a 12?
Good question.
Because it's an EP. There's only 4 songs.
That's one reason. But
the other reason?
The other reason? No. The other reason is we printed out the covers and the lyric sheet for this EP back in 2002, but we never got around to filling them.
I did not know that.
Yeah, so we had the covers. I've been storing them in my garage the past 25 years. And now we have the vinyl to put inside the covers, so...
Oh, so you've already got the covers when you get the vinyl?
The covers were printed literally 25 years ago.
You're getting vintage covers here.
I was gonna say, are you guys gonna have a little get together where you put the records in these covers
actually we are. It's called a stuffing party. There's also posters, lyric sheets, inserts, postcards.
Wow. Are you gonna seal them up, or are you gonna sign any of them? Are you gonna do any of that kind of thing?
We're gonna put MySpace stickers in them.
And Ted's phone number, right? So you can get, contacts with these people that call you up and go, wow, that is great.
Actually, I'm the one who needs the phone number.
Oh, man, that's fantastic. And what's going to be the cost for this 10-inch?
I think we're going for $25
Canadian.
Oh, okay. What is that in Czechoslovakian cash money?
$20 US.
$20 US. Well, that's good. That's a reasonable price. And as far as that, are you going to have other merch? Will you have time to get, like, T-shirts or anything else ready for that?
So, when I was offered a position in the band, they gave me a Promolicious jersey of my own. Mm-hmm. I will be auctioning that very shirt off that night. That's offered.
we have a CD from, actually, the Overload CD and the SuperChevyMettle CD. We have both those CDs on sale. Probably, we haven't talked about pricing, but...
Yeah, you're right. Never thought about it.
But we'll have a very good price on the CDs if anyone's interested in picking up some CDs.
So is that how you got in the band, because you had that jersey that you were going to audition? Is that how you...
That was my reward for joining the band. Yeah. That and a beer and a shot. It's like, welcome aboard, here's a beer and a shot.
A beer and a shot.
Nothing. I'm wearing a jersey, I had a beer and a shot.
That's really, really cool. Now, any plans on, because it's a reunion show, and the first one, in 15 years, of possibly recording it or having somebody videotape it, or have you not thought that far ahead?
A good question. These are some great ideas. For real.
Someone's got to, we need to get some video of that night.
Yeah, we do.
So I know the bar usually sets up a video camera to record things, but
nowadays there could be 100 people in the audience with their phones up, so it's all...
There will be some video there for sure.
Yeah, right? But phone videos normally suck. If they're set up to do it, come on, go the extra mile, let them do it for you. If the worst comes to worst, you can maybe get an audio recording out of it. But
maybe we'll wait for a token gig, because usually they would just run, they would record it for free, wouldn't they? Yeah. Remember? Yeah, through the soundboard.
They don't usually do that for Canadian bands. They're kind of racist.
We're only half Canadian.
Well, that makes it worse. They'll question you at the door.
Audio for sure. I know the sound man quite well.
Yeah, we got to get them.
Yeah, that would be definitely something I would think, as a momentum, if not for you, for your fans or whatever. Now, how long have you been thinking of doing this? How long has this been in the works? Did this just come up overnight, somebody called somebody and said, hey, we should get together and play? Or how did you decide to do this after 15 years?
So a lot of this actually hinged on our bassist, Juergen. He had a job opportunity in Germany to move back to Germany. So we've always been on good terms, and we've always kept in touch and everything. But Juergen went out there for, how many years was he out there? Seven, eight years. Yeah. So that actually, we weren't ever going to do a reunion show without, obviously him and his availability. So he recently moved back to Baltimore, which is a lot easier than Germany. Thought was always there, and the heart has always been there, but now the logistics have come together.
We started talking about it during COVID, but Juergen was living in Germany.
Right.
But then when he came, wait a minute, now we could actually do that.
Since he's been back, it has not taken long, and we're like, let's do it.
Have you guys, back in the day when you played, all over Canada and the States, did you ever in any way plan on going over to Europe? Have you done any of that or thought of that?
We did look into the UK, doing a UK tour at some point. We never did get over there, but who knows? We did talk about it. Yeah, it
just never. Even at one time, I did meet Provin, some record rep in London, England. I don't know. I was just going to Europe for whatever reason, and Provin mentioned to meet that guy, and I did go meet him in London, England, but nothing really came of it.
Yeah.
But booking some gigs in England.
So you were over there going to talk to somebody at that time?
Yeah, I met I met him at lunch for some quick meeting about possible gigs. He would have been her agent booking gigs. I don't know if I didn't follow through or we didn't follow. I don't know what really
never happened anyway.
Yeah. We focused on, I think, still on the new album at the time, and we never really got around to
it. What was this guy's name? Do you remember?
It was Paul McCart, something.
I don't know, some bloke. Isn't he that guy that got run over at Abbey Road? And I think that might have been why you guys didn't
get him out. That's right, never mind. Paul is dead.
Well, he's getting there, but we won't go into that. Anyway, guys, I'm going to let you go, and I wish you guys the best as far as that show, and definitely, like I said, record in some way or fashion that show, because, you know, you'll regret it otherwise.
Very great idea.
We appreciate that very much.
All right, brothers. You guys have a good night now, man. Don't let the crickets bite.
All right, thanks a lot,
James. Wait a minute. I had one more question for you guys, and this is for my fellow Canadians. Are any of you guys into curling, or have any of you guys ever, driven a Zamboni?
I've done curling once in my life, and I've never driven a Zamboni.
Ice skating and hockey, that's the end.
Yeah, you got to get on that, man. That should be, as far as I know, that was every Canadian's dream, to drive a Zamboni. All right, with that said, buddy, we'll let you guys go. You guys, right. Like I said, you know, get back to practicing, you know, maybe not tonight, but next week, and hopefully everything turns out great.
Cracking the whip on him, dude. Worked on this interview.
There you go. Go for it, man. Go for it. All right, man. You guys take care.
You too. Take it easy, James.
All right. See ya.
Cheers.
Bye-bye. All right. That was the boys from Blasternaut. And as you heard, they've got the reunion show coming up October 19th over in Windsor. And they'll be running ads for it on Facebook. And I will, of course, keep you updated as far as, you know, any details. Aren't they planning on having a vinyl record release party for that? 10-inch. Which is really, really cool. They're going to be hand-stuffing these vinyl records coming over from the UK or Europe. And that's a special thing. That's something that tells me they care about their fans. And they want to go the extra mile for them and stuff. So I want to thank Blasternaut being on the show. And if you guys haven't heard of them, check them out. They're obviously on YouTube. You can see some of their videos. Live stuff and otherwise, and they're also on the streaming platform Spotify and probably all the rest. Anyway, with that said, I'd also like to mention that if you're digging these shows, these interviews, please hit the like button, you know, and maybe subscribe if you haven't. It doesn't cost anything. It just helps me know that there's interest in these interviews, and I've got some good ones coming down the line, so stay tuned. Anyway, with that being said, this has been Jimmy Jive and Motor City Rock Talk saying, keep rocking. Deep days like a dream.